You see, now it is displaying. Okay. So, you see, wheel, open the start pipe. Where is the start pipe? Here. This is for a ring beam. Wheel, go. Already it is. Okay. We go to the view pool. The blue pool is made from this blue. The ring beam and outer column. It's selected. Now you see, we go to the view like this. Processing is completed. We go to the report. Here the section course and MZ, moment Z and loading case. Factor load. That will be selected. Here this is 55.413 and this is 4.8. You see here. 55.4 and 4.8 is the torsion for the moment this, but this 55, that is the maximum maximum bending moment at here, and you see this 55 is the maximum for beam 16, and if we will at the support means 250 mm away from the node. If you will check there, you see, this is 15, this is 16, okay, this one is 16, we click here. And you see, for 206, this is 55.44, and here is 55.41. Here, at edge of the column, how much? This is 0.25. This is 22.40. 22.40. This is the your support movement. 22.40 is support movement. Is the support. Green check. Now we check. The movement, span movement. For span movement. Okay. The span here we'll get. The span movement. How will you get the span movement? You see, we go to report on this section force MZ. Now, in case all factor load will be selected, and you see, where is the MZ? Is 7.9 is a positive. And negative is 13, is the highest. The maximum value in between positive and negative. So this is 13.876. You see the support movement mid span movement is 13.867. And corresponding the torsion is 3.65. Corresponding, this is 3.655. This value. Now we check this maximum shear. The maximum shear, we will go to the report and section force. Here the FY. I am loading. Same factor load, all factor loads to be selected and we'll check here. You see, FI is 30.485 and here shear, this is 30.485, it is at a D distance. This is, here is the load, this is the D distance. And corresponding torsion for this 30, here the torsion is 2.793. Okay, thank you.